Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to another GTA 5 online video, and in this video I'm going to be reviewing the brand new Ubermach Niob. So this car right here is based on the BMW i8, which is quite obvious, it looks pretty much identical to the real thing. Not gonna lie, the BMW i8, I love the front end, both like in real life and in game, but in real life, the rear end of the i8 always throws me off. I'm not really the biggest fan of it, so when I got this car, I was really hoping that they would at least fix the rear end. Nah. it looks just as strange as the i8 in real life. So yeah, if you guys did not know, this vehicle right here is a hybrid in real life. And if you start it up, in this game at least, you'll hear a beep. I don't know if you guys said that, but yeah, it looks great though, looks really nice, like it a lot. So yeah, it does have the butterfly doors, just like the actual car, so that's really, really nice. And the car actually sounds pretty good, I like it. Check out the interior seems, hold up, oh wow, okay, interior's actually pretty nice. Hold on, one last thing before we actually go ahead and customize this thing. Let's go ahead and open everything up. Would you take a look at that? Let's take a look. Let's bring out the flashlight. So that's the front end. There's literally no space whatsoever. How about the rear end? There's also none. Wow, so this vehicle has like zero luggage space. Hold on, is there some like back here? Like just a little slot just to put in your handbag or something. Or your backpack, I don't know. That's a little bit right there. It's not a lot, well, it's pretty much nothing. Might as well have nothing, to be honest. Actually, nah, it's better than nothing, you know? Anyways, let's go ahead and customize this thing, shall we? One last thing, almost completely forgot about this. So this car right here, you guys can buy in the Legendary Motorsport website. So here it is, part of bottom dollar bounties. And yeah, pretty cool. This is the newest DLC in the game currently, or the time I'm recording this. It is a total of 1.8 million, so 1.880, round it up. I guess we're looking at around 1.9, I guess. So yeah, quite pricey, well, very pricey. I guess it's pretty much standard. I mean, in terms of pricing, it's pretty much standard in GTA nowadays. This does have HSW upgrade, surprisingly. So that's pretty cool. If you guys do want me to check that out, like a separate video on HSW upgrades, you guys can let me know down in the comment section. So yeah, let's go ahead and customize the vehicle. Alright, it's time to customize the vehicle. Also, if you guys do like this video, consider subscribing to the channel. Helps me out a lot and I really, really appreciate it. Okay, 23 categories. Starting off with arch covers. So you got a street kit, a bolt-on kit, and a race kit. What the... Okay, yeah, this is... off to a great start! Yeah. I don't think anyone will ever put on the street kit, or the bolt-on kit, or the race kit, though. Like, what is this? Also, look at the fitment! The wheel, why is the wheel, like... Man, this thing needs some spaces, bro. Ain't no way. Alright, let's just put on the armor upgrades. Brakes maxed out, front bumpers. So you got extended trim. Carbon extended trim, hold on, let me zoom in a little. Yeah, extended trim, just a little splitter down there. We got a winged trim, pretty cool. Then we have a performance trim. What does that change? Oh, it adds a little black piece in the bottom, like in the middle of the bottom grille there. We have carbon performance trim, splitter, this one's just straight up called splitter, alright, with some canards, pretty cool. And splitter with race intakes, ooh! That is actually pretty cool. So we have big vents on like each side of the bumper now, like the front bumper, like on the left and right side. Look at that. That's actually really cool. The thing that's not cool is that we have, if we want to have that race intake, we're going to have to put on the splitter and the canards, which is kind of annoying. Huh. I guess I'll go for carbon extended trim. There we go. Moving on to rear bumpers. You got, oh my god, I've never seen an i8. Where the black bit at the back is all painted. Usually i8s, they all have like, the rear end is all painted in black color, right? But this, seeing it painted in primary, oh my god, that looks strange. Alright, moving on, we have a carbon bumper which replaces the black part with carbon, which actually might do that. Does look very nice. I'm a carbon man. For diffuser, we add in a nice little diffuser at the bottom there, which I actually don't really mind. I actually do kind of like it. And then a secondary diffuser bridge. Okay, I see. Pretty cool. And then we have second. Wait, so they tell me we have a diffuser, but no, like, no carbon diffuser. Okay, never mind. I guess I'm going with carbon bumper then. Alright. Great. Off to a great start. Okay, engine, max it out. Alright. Looking good. Sounds great, by the way. Yeah, I actually like the way this thing sounds. Okay. Is it new exhaust note? Not sure. Moving on to exhaust pipes. So the exhaust pipe is like kind of hidden away under there, behind the bumper. And then we have rounded bore, which has in the exhaust pipe in the center there. And I have twin rounded, sharpened, twin exit, twin titanium, triple exit, and triple titanium. Okay, pretty cool, I think. I kind of like the sharpened bore. Ooh. I'm not sure, to be honest. I think we can go for, yeah, sharpened bore. There you go. Moving on to front grille. We got stock right here. Front end looks nice, actually. Very nice. Okay, primary grille, carbon, grated, horizontal, mesh, rigid. Rigid? So whatever. Race grille. Can't really see a difference, but cool, I guess. I'm gonna go for carbon. Carbon, man. Back at it again. Let's go. Moving on to hoods. We got stock, secondary, trim hood divider, divider, secondary hood divider, smoothed hood. Oh, okay, I see. It get rid of the vent. Interesting. Wait, does it? Yeah. And then we have secondary smoothed, and we have trim intake cover, and then secondary intake cover, and twin vented. Stock might be the best option, to be honest. No carbon, unfortunately. How dare you, Rockstar. I guess I'm just have to stick with stock, right? Yeah, stock it is then. Should I go for the hood divider? Nah. Alright, moving to lights. We got stock and xenon. Might go for xenon, actually. Kind of suits the car. Yeah. There we go. Moving on, livery. Oh, this thing is livery, surprisingly. So I have white arrow stripe. And then we have black arrow stripe. Okay, pretty cool. And then we have white contour, black contour, old school iconic. Oh my, don't tell me this is the Need for Speed Most Wanted. Is this the Need for Speed Most Wanted M3 GTR livery? Well, they tried to replicate it, right? Is it? I'm just assuming that it is because I see random blue lines. And then we have old school grayscale. Radiance, alright. We have Beast 76. And then we have modular race. Dense electric. Ooh, modular race and dense electric. These are some pretty nice race liveries. Actually, they're kinda funky, not gonna lie. Especially with like modular, with that kind of glowing type of outline livery thingy. I don't know how to explain it, but look at Dens though. Look at the big electric ball at the back. Okay, that kind of throws it off, not gonna lie. But the design of the livery for the front end is really nice. I actually like the design delivery for the front end. They cooked halfway through, but for the back, they kind of just threw it in a bin, to be honest. Anyways, moving on. Side mirrors, you got primary, secondary, carbon. There we go. Custom. Okay, I guess that. Okay, it makes it look a little pointier. Ah, very. It's like those type of BMW side mirrors. Which model has them? M3, M4? I don't know. Alright. So we got primary, secondary, carbon, custom mirrors, primary custom, secondary custom, carbon custom, and race mirrors. I think. Let's go for carbon custom. Move on to license plate. Let's give it standard, to be honest. License plate. Let's do that. And then moving on to roof. Secondary carbon. There we go. Ooh. That actually makes it look a lot nicer now. So you got secondary carbon roof. Here we got aerial. Vortex generators. Secondary roof with aerial with generators. Carbon roof with aerial generators. Roof scoop. Roof on eye is crazy, by the way. Secondary roof scoop and a carbon roof scoop. I'm gonna go for carbon roof. That looks very nice. I'll come back to respray in a moment. Moving on to skirts, 12 options. We got primary, secondary, carbon. We have slipstream skirts. Yeah, we have, and then we have street skirts. And yeah, street, secondary street, carbon street, wing skirts, secondary wing, carbon wing, canards. Oh my god, why would you want this on your i8? Why? Alright, that's all the side skirts that this car has. Let's go for carbon skirts. There we go. Moving on to spoiler. Damn, spoiler on the i8? I've actually never thought of that before. Okay, let's see. Spoilers. Lip spoiler. Why is it painted in black? I don't know. Ducktail. Oh, wait, that's the same thing. Oh, they're a little different. Okay, never mind. Ducktail. Secondary ducktail. Trim sport spoiler. That is tiny. Then we have carbon sport spoiler. GT wing. Ooh! That is a very low GT wing, like the way it's positioned. And then we have GT wing Mark II. Once again, Mustang GTD vibes coming from the spoiler, not gonna lie. Then we have a bumper mounted. Okay, interesting. And we have a race wing. Oh my god. I don't think I've ever seen an eye with this type of spoiler before. Holy crap, that is insane. To be honest, I don't think I'm gonna go for a spoiler. Nah, why not? Actually, yeah, no thanks, no spoiler. Okay, suspension. Lowered, street, sport, and competition. Damn, you can slam this thing low. Oh wow, alright. Transmission, boom. Turbo tuning, boom. Wheels, yeah, wheels definitely gotta change, dude. These wheels are not it. I may have an idea. Frost white on that. Respray, let's go metallic. Ooh, oh shoot! Hold on a second. Oh, that's actually nice. Oh, shadow silver, sick. Hold on a second. Maybe a lighter shade of blue. Oh wow, wait, the eye actually looks really good in a lot of colors. Wait, what? Yo! The eye actually looks good in a lot of colors. Surf blue, I might go for surf blue. I don't go for surf blue that often, I think. Light blue? Well, I've made up my mind. I've, you know, finally decided. I'm gonna go for light blue. Pearlescent surf blue. Like pearlescent surf blue. Alright, there we go. Secondary, that changes the black trims around the car. So for that, I'm just put classic black, which, okay, it's already classic black. Moving on to interior. I think I'm gonna just make it white, to be honest. Frost white. Yeah, look at the interior. This car actually has a pretty nice interior, not gonna lie. I like it. Alright, there we go. Bada bing, bada boom. I think I am done. Check the blueprint size. Yep, there we go. Nice, and yeah, I'm pretty much done here. There we go. Okay, nice. Let's go ahead and test it out. Out in the sun, let's take a look at the i8. I is looking solid. Oh, right. Oh, okay. All right, let's go for a quick test drive. It already feels kind of understeery, not gonna lie. I don't know. Maybe I'm expecting too much. Acceleration is quick, by the way. Acceleration feels fast for some reason, and this is not even HSW. And let's go. Okay, this thing is quick. Also, the camera feels very zoomed out. I don't know, it could just be me. Alright, let's try it. Launch is good. Well, I did do like the rev thingy, so. Look at it climb though. It's climbing. 120? Alright. Oh wow. Okay. Let's just brake before I crash. It looked like we reached 120 by the time we reached at the end there. So straight line speed for this thing is actually solid. Let's try again, but this time. I messed it up. I'm trying to do a double clutch. There we go. not sure if that really helped the car that much. 110, 120, okay, that's pretty much the same. Alright, damn, this car is way faster than I thought it would be. Alright, well then, do I have anything else to say about this vehicle? No, not really, so I guess I'll just end it here. So if you guys did enjoy, okay, the eye actually looks very nice. Man, the eye looks so good, dude, but the rear end just throws me off so much. Look at the rear end. Like, why? Anyways, we'll just look at the front end of the car for now. I guess this is gonna be it for today's video. Can I please look at the front end of the car? So this is gonna be it for today's video. So if you guys did enjoy, be sure to drop a like on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you guys haven't already. And I'll see you all in the next one. And peace.